Hi, my name's Kevin Mitchell, aka Bob Evans, and this is my podcast. Wearing out a hole in my heart on the couch from when you went away. It is exciting. It's been, I made the record in September, October last year, so it was quite a while ago. So it's always difficult waiting for an album to get released, no matter how long the amount of time is, but yeah, it's just going to feel good for it to actually be on shelves and just for people to start hearing it, you know. You have to sort of tread a fine line between sort of being able to open yourself up more to people but not take yourself so seriously. Because there is that danger, when you're talking about yourself all the time and you're talking about, you know, your music and your inspiration and where everything comes from, you know, I can see how you could just fall into the trap of just beginning to think like that all the time and just turning into an ultra serious wanker, which I hope to try and avoid. But, yeah. And lyrically, I felt like I didn't really have anything to write about. And I think all that really, in retrospect, when I look back at it, and I think all that really meant was I'd run out of things to kind of fall back on lyrically. So the whole writer's block thing kind of really forced me to push myself and challenge myself. And with the lyrics, you know, I just had to sort of write, basically just really discipline myself, just sit down with a pen and paper at my kitchen table and, you know, and just write words, just any words, just so at least I was writing something. And sometimes it would be pages and pages, and about four versions of the song would be written and thrown away before I started writing stuff that I liked. And that was pretty much the process that I went through to get through it. And after a while, once I started to get through it, then the lyrics were coming real easy, you know, like the first things, they were just writing themselves. But I needed to tap into something, you know, and something that was just going to give me more satisfaction. And I think, yeah, I got there in the end. Once I did, it was, you know, it was great, and the songs were just coming thick and fast, and the whole process became very, very easy. With the Bob stuff, the songs that come out are just a result of the situation. It's just me on my own with an acoustic guitar, just like the songs that come out with Jebs are the product of that situation, four people in a room with electric guitar. Brad's got a real knack for producing stuff really warmly, and that's what I heard on the Josh Rouse albums, and that's what I wanted for my record. So yeah, it's got that same sort of warm, kind of understated kind of feel to it, you know. It's not produced within an inch of its life. It's fairly natural. There's not effects all over everything. It's pretty natural and warm. And yeah, I mean, I don't know, the other ones, Temperance Union, kind of, I try to avoid the, anything that I do that starts to sound like Tim Rogers, I tend to stop, because, you know, I've always said how I felt about Tim Rogers and Neil and the influence that they've had on me, so I'm trying to distance myself a bit from that.
On my mind, oh, you've been on my mind.
I really like to one day, towards the end of this record's life, I really like to release some of the demos, or all the demos that I did. Because I was demoing this record for about 6 months, and I was quite obsessive about it, and I demoed all the string parts and all the brass parts, and I had a very definite ideas about how I wanted these things to sound. And because I was spending so much time on it and treating it, these demos so seriously, I'd experiment with lots of different sounds and lots of different lines, and just using a keyboard, and that's how I do all the brass and the strings and stuff. So I reckon about 50% of that stuff I demoed at home, and the guy at the session musos just listened to my demo and played what I'd done. The other 50% is stuff that they did on the spot, you know, like things like lead, any kind of solo-y stuff they would just do on the spot, because I can't really write for that. But yeah, I had a very definite idea about the type of record I wanted to make and the type of instruments I wanted to use and how how much more expansive I wanted to get with all the instrumentation, you know. But they still write songs mostly on guitar and everything, but not rely on the guitar to convey everything, you know, to sort of, you know, using the strings and the brass and pianos and all those other instruments just to make it a bit more colourful and a bit less sort of traditional in the sense of where my background is, which is all sort of guitar, indie rock, you know.